Hello, and good morning. So, today we are flying up to Toronto from Fort Lauderdale. And we are in the Air Canada livery. Bye bye bye. Have a look at this airport while we're here. Here we are, Fort Lauderdale. Nice detail in this airport as well. Look at that. Shame they don't have the windows inside. As soon as you come out, then you can see the windows. Anyway, let's get into our cockpit. And get this flight underway. All right. Our little NavMap flight today. Our plan is there. So we're in the Miami, sort of Florida region, and we are heading north to Toronto. All right, let's jump into the cockpit and get this powered up. So, fly pad on. Here we go, and let's get the flight plan from Simbrief. There we are. Our fuel today is 9,000. There we go. And let's power this on. That. There we go. On. Let's get a bit of lighting in here. Here we are. Seatbelts can come on, and no smoking, nav lights, throw to auto, adhere's 1, 2, and 3, and that's good for now. All right, let's put a little bit of brightness here and here, so we're running live weather. Today. Okay. Let's get the flight plan into the MacDo. There we go. Alrighty. There we are. Clear that. Hey, Cap. Hey, how are you? I'm doing this. You're in school, are you? Okay, weight and balance. Let's call for the passenger manifest and start boarding. Here we go. So today we're in Fort Lauderdale. Yeah, yeah, I'll stream as well later. I had some time today in the morning, so I thought I'll do a stream, but I will stream later on. Okay, boarding has started. And let's go back to our initialization and let's call in the flight plan. There we go, flight level 390. Yeah, yeah, you will. But I'll see you. I'll be with you tonight. Enjoy school. There we go. Flight number, why is it not taking our flight number? Let's put that in. ACA321. Flight number in use. ACA321. Okay. A0321. Okay. Here we are. And so we're all done there. Let's go to our flight plan. Departure. It's 28 right via arc. Transition is one way. Mm-hmm. transition, insert. And then let's go to perch. Right, good. And here we go, arrival on 33 right. And arrival and leaning 3. Ridod is our via, and we can insert. Okay, let's have a look and see, do we have any flight discontinuities? There we go, there's one.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the flight deck, on behalf of myself, your captain, the first officer, and cabin crew, I'd like to take this time to welcome you aboard our flight. We're just wrapping up some paperwork up front here and waiting to receive final numbers from the ground crew, then we'll be on our way. Flight attendants will be coming through the cabin shortly with a very important safety briefing. We do ask that you give them your full, undivided attention as they review the safety operations of this Airbus aircraft. We do appreciate your business having you aboard this flight. If there's anything we do to make your flight any more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask. Welcome aboard.
And there we go, that's our flight plan done. Okay, boarding is done, so we can go back to our initialization page and put in our zero fuel weight, and our block fuel was 9,000. There we go. And our fuel predicted, so our CG is 24.9. So that should be good. Let's just have a look. 24.9. So if that's 24, there we go. All right. Let's just see what our flight control says. Up 7. Yep. Okay. And that looks like up 7. Yep. Good. All right. Let's just put that on. Here we are, and that's good. Okay, so let's there we go, performance, there we go, flaps 1, flex temp 52, V1, V rotates, and V2. There we go. All right. Let's turn this down a little bit, eh? There we go. All righty then. We are set. Let's set our Q&H today. (3009). There we go. Constraints. We'll display those. And there we go. Flight level today is 390. There we are. And we are all good to go. There we go. Transition is 18,000 transition, and all good. All right, turn on the fuel pumps and APU. Start. There we go. Pop the beacon on. Ooh, look at those clouds. Okay. All looks good.
Once again, we'd like to welcome you on board. Your safety is our top priority, so we appreciate
Oh, so when you close the door, it does get rid of the sound, eh? Okay. APU is humming on. There we go. We can see the vapor, the jet, or the heat exhaust. There we go. And the APU is available. And there we go. APU bleed is on. Okay. So we are going to push with the tail going over here. So we can get the runway over there. There's the threshold there. All right. Let's call for pushback.
Cockpit to ground.
This is ground. Stand by.
Okay, we can start pushback.
Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
We are cleared for start and push. Parking brake set.
Okay, cleared for push start. Please release parking brake.
Parking brake is released.
Parking brakes are released.
Commencing pushback. You can start the engines in sequence.
It will start in the sequence.
Okay, let's start our engines. Engine 2. And let's set our speed brake. There we go. And engine 1. That's our taxiway there. Hello, why did my pushback truck disappear? Oh well, never mind. There we go, we can hold here and stop pushback. Parking brake is set. And there we go. Don't know what happened with the pushback, but yeah, Microsoft has a mind of its own these days. Okay. So let's arm that. Bar our auto brake is max in case of rejected takeoff. Flaps go to 1. Engine is available, so let's go back to normal. APU off, and there we are. Okay, we're all good. tractor lights can come on. Let's start taxi. What? Have I lost controls again? Hold on, let me just set something up here. Control 3. Okay, nose wheel steering, disconnect. Why do we have no nose wheel steering? Really? Nose wheel steering disconnect. Must have this something to do with the pushback. Stop pushback. Parking brake. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, good. Something is going. When it goes, eh? No worries. We are sorted now. So let's just tell cabin crew.
Flight attendants, please prepare for takeoff.
And let's continue taxi. But at least we can sort it out. There we go. There we go. See? Sorted. No problem at all. Let's hope nothing else goes wrong. Okay, landing lights. Let's pop them on. And ready for takeoff as well. And then TCAS. TCAS. Okay, all good. Let's go. Hey, when it goes wrong, it goes wrong. But we just have to fly the plane. There we go. Alright. Let's go. Here we go. Speed alive. 80 knots. 100 knots. And rotate. Here we go. Landing gear up. Flaps up. There we go, lever climb. And autopilot on. And there is Florida. We are airborne. There's the airport. We can clean up the top. Here we go. Six thousand feet. Go, there's the city, and then we have this reserve. Quite a definite border there, eh? Quite a laid out city, I must say. There's got to be crocodiles down there, eh? Or alligators. What do they have in Florida? Alligators? There we're doing 10,000 feet. Landing lights can come off. And we can release them from their seat belts. And there's the coast. Atlantic Ocean. We've got transition altitude at 18,000 feet. And according to the flight plan, here we are. Good. Ops 15. Okay. Okay, where are we? 17,000 feet, approaching transition altitude. And let's continue our climb. 39,000 feet. And set the standard. Set the standard. And we are continuing our climb to 39,000 feet. Still following the coast, heading north. We are. Ooh, a lot of sun coming in from that direction. Twenty-3,500 feet. Everything up top looks good. Lot of live traffic here. I should switch this off, this live tracker traffic. Twenty-5,000 feet. I'll get to cruise and then I will call the cabin crew for a cup of coffee. We're still following the coast. I wonder what the weather change is going to look like. We left Florida, which is quite warm, I guess, and we're going to head up to Toronto, which is freezing. So this is where we are on our course. So we're just going to be crossing over the coast and then heading towards this VOR 11350. So let's pop that in to the VOR. So that is CHS. So CHS, and there we are. And then when we are UIW, where's that? Let's see, UIW. EYW. Ah, it's behind us, which is also the same frequency, so no problem. That will change when we get closer to it. Look at our wind today, 275 crosswind at 91 knots. Feet. Thank you. approaching 35,000 feet. They're approaching 38,000 feet. Thousand to go. Approaching 39,000 feet. Thank you.
and gentlemen, once again from the flight deck, your captain speaking. We've just reached our cruising altitude for the flight. As again is settling, and I do want to remind you to please keep your feet and elbows clear from the aisle, as the flight attendants will be coming through the cabin with galley cards shortly. Also, one more reminder to please refrain from congregating near the front galley where the flight deck door is located. Thank you.
There we are, top of our cruise. Passenger announcements from fly by wire, and we're on our way. 900 nautical miles to go, about 2 hours, and then we will be on the ground at the Toronto Airport. I am gonna go and just grab a cup of coffee and I'll be right back. Stay tuned. Here we go. I am back. Solar Hawk. Hey, mate. How are you? How are you? Sorry, I was just away making a quick cup of coffee. I reached my cruise altitude and I decided to leave the cockpit and go and trouble the cabin crew for a cup of coffee. There we go. I am back in the cockpit now. So we're flying to Toronto. We just left Fort Lauderdale. And yeah, there we are. We are on our way. This is what the map looks like. We are. So we left Fort Lauderdale and we're on our way now up to this VOR. And then we will head north to Toronto Pearson, landing runway 33 right. Yeah, yeah, all good, all good. Yeah. And how you doing? How you doing? You all right? You gotta be well. I mean, what else can we do, mate? I mean, the world's going to pot. Yeah. And there's nought we can do about it. We are but pawns on a chessboard. Exactly. Nought. I saw you flying a few days ago. You were flying a biplane. Was that a pit special? Was that a pit that when I jumped in and flew over you? Ah, right, that was a pit. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I thought I would sort of buzz you while you were in the air. Yeah, like you do to me. Oh, by the way, I might have a. Are you still having that problem with your photogrammy? Scenery in Microsoft Flight Sim, because I think I found a solution. Well, I think I found a solution, mate. And where apparently it's a such a simple solution. So hold on, let me try and remember. 1 second. So you had to go into, let's have a look. Where was it? Was it here? No. Was it here? Ah, yeah. Right. So in your users, app data, and local, there is a directory called Flight Simulator. So open that and you'll see two files which are called maps cache and overrides.json. Copy them and put them somewhere else. Okay, copy all the content from that folder, put them somewhere else, then delete the originals in that folder. And then when you start Microsoft Flight Sim, it will recreate the map cache. And apparently you can then switch on your photogrammy and Bing and all that. And a lot of people said that's solved their problem and it's such a simple fix. So let me just, I'll show you. So in here, I'll just show you. Hold on a second. Hold on. Let's go to there. So you can see that folder there. So where you want to go is you want to go users, whatever the name is, then app data, okay, and then local, and then there's a folder here that says flight simulator. Remember, we used to go into packages. Don't need to do that. There is a folder that says flight simulator. Open that, take a copy of all of that and put it somewhere else, and then delete this, okay, and then Microsoft Flight Sim will recreate the folders, and apparently that will work. And a lot of people are quite pissed off that Microsoft haven't figured it out with such a simple little fix. But yeah, give it a go. You can come into the sure, if you get confused, which is highly likely, but yeah, no worries, you can always call me anytime. So how far are we? We've picked up the VOR. There we are. Here's the VOR. We're 180 nautical miles away from our waypoint, which is our VOR. Yeah, it was just something I found while scouring the forums, and then I came across this and I thought, okay. That sounds like a solar hawk problem. Although I don't know who this Solar Phoenix bloke is. Can we still see the coast? Hardly. But it was a nice departure. Oh, Solar Phoenix. Sorry, not Phoenix. Yeah. If it's Phoenix, what do they call Phuket? Phuket. That starts with a PH. It's like chemist. Cheese and chutney sandwiches, or keys and chutney sandwiches? I don't know. School. Yeah, you're right. Moog? Hey? Moog. I don't know what that is. Nah, I don't know what that is. I mean, it is the moon in the sky. No, you lost me there. That is very strange. You lost me. You losing me is strange. Oh, right, okay. Oh, yes, okay. Yeah, okay, got it. I know the company. See, why didn't you start off with that? Cool. All right. Nice, gentle Air Canada. And two on that fix, by the way, I actually did that fix, and what it did was actually switch off my Photogrammy and Bing, and I didn't realize. I went back in and switched it back on, and yeah, and then it sort of updated something in those files because the size changed. So I'm convinced that that fix will work for you. If it doesn't, then back to the drawing board. Let's have a look at the drone. Whoa! The drone is really messed up. I swear it follows the curvature of the Earth. Let's see, is that the curvature of the Earth? No, that's the curvature of the Earth, right there. Noisy, noisy, noisy. Are you not streaming today? Seriously? All right, hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Let me just pull it up again. Well, you delete everything. So hold on, let's just go back to that again. So users, and app data, local, flight simulator is the folder you want to go into. Take that, right click, copy, put it somewhere else like your desktop or whatever, and then delete all of the content inside the flight simulator folder, and then Microsoft Flight Sim will recreate it. No worries. Yeah, yeah, give it a go, let me know. Yeah, I'll probably stream again in the evening around 6 or something. Around 6. Yeah. So you can join in there if you want. Maybe we fly, let's fly, I've been flying the Asobo Cessna. I am quite surprised. It's not a bad plane, eh? the Asobo Cessna. Yeah, I was quite surprised. The pits. Yeah, maybe we can do a formation sort of, or try to do a formation flight in the pits. What liveries are available for the pits? Okay, a sort of a loose formation if you want. Is that they have the red pit special livery and the... Well, let me find a really nice livery for the pit special. And then maybe we can do a little flight in the pit. Like the Red Bull, a Red Bull livery. Let's see, a Sobo pits. Pits. There we go. Pit special. None. Wow. No one's done any liveries for it, unless it's somewhere else. Hold on, let's see. Pits. Okay, there's a pit special. There's the Oracle one, the very famous Oracle livery. Yeah, not much love given to the pits, unfortunately. Oh well, we'll see how it goes. Maybe we'll do Cessnas. Yeah, it is the pits. Why don't you stream? Can you stream the DJI flight? How much did you pick up the DJI Mini for? $275, that ain't bad. From Argos. People still go to Argos, do they? DJI, let's have a look. DJI. Which one is it? The DJI Mini 2. DJI Air. Oh, okay, hold on. There we go. $269, and then there's a combo for $350. What's that got? Ah. Did you get some good video from it as well? Is it 4K, right? Let's see, does Costco have it? Let's see, DJI. How many batteries does it come with? What's the combo? What's the difference then? ...30 minutes on a single charge. And how long to charge? Ah, 120 minutes. 2 hours to charge. So yeah, so you got video resolution is 1920 by 1080p. At 60 frames per second. Interesting. I prefer my own drones that I built. But they are in no way as stable as a DJI. They're like Ferraris. You touch the sticks and they disappear. Yeah, they're just very, very quick, my drones are. So we should be approaching. No, we're still quite some way out. There we go. Yeah, it is. I was actually thinking about buying a glider. Just a basic, simple free flight glider. Or maybe a glider with an electric motor on the front. So I can take it up and then cut the motor. Like an electric version of the Birds of Time or whatever. The old Birds of Time. Fumbat. Let's have a look. Fumbat. Fumbat. Is a triple action cream, is it? Hold on, let's have a look. Ah, flight test. Fun bat. Let's see what it looks like. Oh, right, okay. Yeah, I've built similar planes already. Flight test, you can do it from, yeah. I've built similar, foam board, for example. You can make them out of foam board. And then just cut it up. Yeah, flight test. But yeah, I got loads of electric motors for my drones, so any one of those will work. Not a problem. Problem is over here, you know, you got to do all that licensing nonsense. I mean, I have got it, I mean, for my drone, but you know, you try and go to a park where they fly and they just look at you strange and they go, can you fly? And I go, of course I can fly. I fly drones. Then they hate you. As soon as you say you fly drones, they hate you. Yeah, it's like skiers and snowboarders. They don't get on too well either, do they? On the levels, what's the levels? I don't know what that is. Is that a place? The levels. The Somerset level. Oh yeah? That's a load of farmland. Is that public ground or is it farmland? Oh yeah. Okay, good. Is that by Western Supermare, is it? Is that where Western Supermare is? No. Okay, Glastonbury, yep. Yeah, I got it. I see it there, yeah. Place called Limpsham, Eastertown, Batch. The wreck of the SS Norman. What the hell is that? All right. Burnham-on-Sea is not far from there. Sharpham. Sharpham. Oh, they even got Brent there. East Brent. Brent House Carberry. Brent Knoll. I'm from Brent, London. Oh, they even got Norfolk. It's like they just copied everything from London. Or did we do that? You know what? I do want to get out of the city at some point and drive down this part of the world. I did, me and the missus did go to, one time we went to, where did we go? Torquay. Yeah, we went to Torquay and then spent some time in Torquay and then took a boat over to Brixham. Now that was a nice getaway. It's a nice part of the world, eh? What do they have at Torquay? The Golden Hind or something, right? A replica of the Golden Hind or something? Yeah, Torquay ain't bad. And I do enjoy a bit of mackerel fishing as well. Yeah, there's a Brixton in South London as well. Very famous. But yeah, I wouldn't mind doing that. I've actually missed doing a bit of mackerel fishing as well. Catch the mackerel and then cook it up on a barbecue. Nothing like it, man. But yeah, so what's the other place? Yeah, Plymouth is not a bad place I want to go either. I do want to check out Plymouth. And where's the... There's so much down there, isn't there? Penzance. There's so much to do down there. I think me and the missus, now we're empty nesters, I think we're going to do, maybe I'm going to try and do a week down there. Yeah, Burnham on Sea. Yeah, maybe sort of like get a cottage or a holiday cottage on an estate or something, you know, and then do this. Take my fishing rods and do a bit of sea fishing. Yeah, Weston-super-Mare. Yeah, I can't find it. Where the hell's Weston-super-Mare? Oh yeah, Weston-super-Mare. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, Weston-super-Mare. There we are. It was right in front of me. Didn't see it. I think I went to Weston-super-Mare once when I was a kid with my dad, or my mum and dad. Took the old Morris Minor Traveller to Weston-super-Mare. Yeah, I remember that. And then we had my uncle. Oh, it took ages in a Morris Minor, man. And then my uncle lived in, what's that? Great Yarmouth. Yeah, Great Yarmouth. My uncle was a doctor in Great Yarmouth. I think that's on the other side of England, isn't it? Great Yarmouth. Yeah, that's up by Norwich. I mean, there's so much to see, so much to do in our, on our little island, eh? I mean, I haven't even done Scotland. I could not tell you the first thing about Scotland. Other than they speak funny. Wales, I'm not too bothered about. I've done Llandudno and Ffestiniog and the old Gogogoch Railway. I've done all that. That's enough. Okay, we should be actually seeing the mainland now. We are. We're on the mainland. Now we keep heading north to Toronto. So we crossed over into, where are we? Let's have a look. We are Charleston. So we crossed over into Charleston. And we will be heading up towards yeah, nothing that strikes me as or Charlottesville. Yeah. Which airports will we be? Let's see. Yeah, nothing strikes me as familiar in the US. Williamsburg County, okay, I've heard of that. Yeah. We got 1 hour 30 minutes to go. About 600 nautical miles. Seems that we got a really strong wind, 56 knots apparently, I think, a wind today. Let's see. Yeah, 56 knot crosswind. Because it's really tracking, look at that. So we're heading to flow, so let's pop that in there. Low. And which one? 4,000 miles away? Nah. There we go. What sort of weather do we have in Toronto? Can we see that yet? Toronto. Ah, it's clear. That's good. But we should see the airport quite well. Aerosoft released an update for the Twin Otter yesterday. I haven't tried it after the update yet, but apparently they fixed some things, but the sound is still shit. But yeah, what to do? Apparently they're still recording the sounds. DC-3. Who makes the DC-3? Is that Aerosoft product as well, right? I don't know. I think Aerosoft is losing the plot. I mean, they're focusing so much on the Xbox user now, and I think that's a bit sad. So flow. So our flight plan, do we have flow in there? No. So we're going to, wow. We've got so much missing from the flight plan. Why is that? I wondered why the CHS. Okay, hold on a second. Let's pop these in because flow. Okay, there we go. Now we're pointing towards flow, and then two bass. There. Yep. Why is it that they misses it? I don't understand. There's so many. Two back. There we go. All right. LYH. Two back. Oxman. There we are. Now that's fixed. Okay. Oh, really? Huh. So that's right now. Flow. Yeah. Two bass. That's right. LYH. Oxman, Lenning, Murky, Riddard, Agbeck. Hold on. Yeah, Riddard, Agbeck. Why do we go back? Murky. Why do we have Riddard twice there? See that? That doesn't make sense. Huh. Let's have a look at that in the flight plan. Lenning, Riddard. Riddard. And then it goes all the way back to that's not right. So let's delete one of them. So let's clear this one. Can we do that? Decel, Riddard, Abbott. Two bass. Okay. Hold on. Two bass. LYH. Lenning. Murky. Riddard. Agbeck. Okay. Then we got another one there. So let's clear that one. Agbeck. And there we go. Yep, that's good. Clear. Okay, and everything else murky. Lenning, Murky, Riddard, Agbeck. And that should look okay. Now let's have a look. There we go. So flight plan. Okay, Oxman, yeah. Murky, Riddard, yeah. There we go. There we go. Sorted. There we are. There we go. No problem. All fixed. Let's see if the drone camera is taking a nosedive. There we go. There we are. So we've passed the halfway mark. Just over an hour to go. And then we will land in the new Toronto airport. New to Microsoft, not new to Canada. Yep, I'm here. Yeah. Pop in the evening, yeah. Let's maybe try and do something together, yeah. I'm up for that. Cool. Sorry, I was just reading something in a forum. But yeah, all right. I'll see you in the evening. All right, mate. Bye-bye. Hello, MSAP. Hey, how are you? We're on our way to Toronto in Air Canada. We left Fort Lauderdale in Florida and heading up north to Toronto. Here we are. There we go. That's our flight plan. How are you today? No work? Are you at the at work or? Is it lunchtime or? We'll start our top of descent in 20 minutes. And then straight into runway 33 right. Getting quite a bit of stutter these days. I don't understand why. Maybe Microsoft servers are shit. Yeah, I haven't seen you flying for a bit. You'll fly from Bordeaux to Nice tonight, eh? Yeah, I'm planning on doing another stream later on in the evening. Probably general aviation. I've been playing around with the Asobo Cessna. Actually, not a bad little aircraft. Probably about 6:30 maybe UK time, so about 7:30. Oh, it's too late for me that. Oh, I don't know. Let's see. When are you planning to fly? Okay, the clouds are rolling in. You're off tomorrow as well as Monday and Tuesday next week. Ah. Yeah, I can happily do a stream tomorrow. No problem. Ping me on Discord and then maybe we can fly together. Look at that, see? The stutter is terrible. Don't know what's going on, why. It's only started since update 8. Sometimes I get a really good, maybe it's just the scenery or whatever. Yes, tomorrow is IKEA Fontainebleau. That was the IKEA we used to go to in Fontainebleau. I'm sure they have many more IKEAs now. Yeah, IKEA in a place called Every. Yeah, I mean, I don't know what's going on. I think Sim Update did something and people are still trying to catch up to update their scenery. There we go, we've got traffic. Where is this traffic? I can never see the traffic. There is traffic there. As we go through, it's contrails. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, I have stutters at certain payware airports as well. And I don't know what's going on. I think it's because Sim Update 8 maybe has caused some issues with some of the way the scenery is optimized. I don't think we'll get a hotfix from Asobo. I think we have to wait for the developers to do their updates. Okay, let's have a look. Where are we? 115 nautical miles from top of descent into Toronto. We've got a bit of weather below us, but we're okay. Did you watch the dev Q&A with Asoba? No, I didn't watch it, but it's available as a video to watch. I did not have time to watch that, actually. So we will start our descent in about 80 nautical miles. Okay, weather's clearing up. Our approach fix at Toronto should be 3,000, yep. So we're going to cross Lake Erie in a minute. And then Toronto is just on the other side of Lake Erie. The Toronto is right ahead of us. We go 60 miles and we will start our descent. Let's have a look and see if I need to put anything into my destination data yet. Nothing yet. In any case, let's call for the ATIS, the weather, sorry. There we go. Let's go weather request, send. There's the company message. Let's return and receive messages, Meta and CYYZ. Really? Wow, this is so out of date. Yep, 3021. And we will use that. 350 at 13. Really? Minus 10 in Toronto right now. Wow. Let me just check that for real. Weather Toronto. Yeah, minus 10. Wow. Definitely gonna have to put the anti-icing on there, I think. We can put it in now, actually. Oh, yep, there we go. So let's pop it in. So 3021. Temperatures 10 minus. No, sorry. Minus 10. And winds are 350, 13. Transition is 18,000. And we go no. There we go. All set. Descent in 28 nautical miles. Got an aircraft coming towards us. Let's have a look. Going across, sorry. Okay. Good, good. Nineteen nautical miles till top of descent. Should be seeing another aircraft coming across us. Coming from the left. Nothing on the TCAS yet. We might just pass it. Okay, getting ready to drop. 3,000 feet. Actually, is it 3,000 feet? Sorry, 7,000 feet is our first constraint. Thank you. Okay. Let's drop. We started our descent into Toronto.
Now would be a good time to wrap up any business you need to take care of as we prepare for approach. If you are up, once you return to your seat, we ask that you remain seated until your aircraft arrives safely at the gate. Flight attendants, please prepare the cabin for a wrap.
Interesting. Look at the wind that we have. Crosswind of 119 nautical miles. I mean, that's ridiculous. Look at our tracking. Any ice formation yet? Let's have a look. Nothing yet. We are minus 10 on the ground. There's the lake in front of us. And if we're close enough, we might get to see Niagara Falls. There we go, 30,000 feet. Thank you. striking 26,000 feet. There we go, 25.5. There, 7,220 knots. Transition at 18,000 feet. QNH has just changed. QNH is now 3025. But this one doesn't refresh for some reason. Across the lake, and then I'll reduce speed to 220. I think it's going to need a little bit of help. Slow down. Okay, we should start increasing our descent. There we go. Okay, good. There we are, we're at 220. And our descent is increasing again. Look how it's tracking. Wow. Still got 102 knot winds here up in the air. Sixty nautical miles to get to 7,000. Yep, that's the jet stream. It's reducing, so that's okay. There's Lake Erie. And Niagara Falls is over there somewhere. Don't know if we can see it. Maybe on the drone camera we could see it, but let's have, yeah, let's hope so. Approaching 20,000 feet. It looks like we might have a little bit of a steep descent after the 7,000. After this waypoint here. We're at 220 and 7,000 is where we need to be. Approaching transition. We can pop on the landing system. Transition 0-2-5. Okay. That looks nice, doesn't it? So 15,000 feet should be okay. Let's have a look around here. Feet. I think we'll be okay. 7,000 there. See, our wind has dropped now to 60 knots. The tracking should be okay once we lose some height. Feet, we'll put on the landing lights. Let's get our spoiler armed. There we go, medium brakes. looking good, looking good. That lake is Lake Erie. To the left of our plane, we have Chicago. If we're looking out of the left-hand side window, we have Chicago, I think. Do we? No, sorry, we have Detroit. Detroit Metropolitan Air, International Airport, and there we are. Look at that. Ten thousand feet. Landing lights are on, and there we go. Seat belts on. And there we are. Nine and a half thousand feet. Once we hit 7,000, we will drop to 3,000. Where does my approach kick in? Right there. No, no, I will do it earlier. I will set my approach to kick in over here at Murky. That's too close to come for comfort there. Niagara Falls is over there somewhere, but we're too far from it on this flight plan. So we're at 7,000. Actually, we can. We can do our approach there, no problem. Looking good. No icing yet. Very strange. Oh, but there's no clouds. We didn't go through any clouds, so we're okay. And Niagara Falls is over there. Get ready for our next descent down to 3,000. Okay, let's drop 3,000. There is Toronto, that's Canada. Slow that down a bit. Wow, how have I gone above my speed? Let's just drop that down back again to 220. Here we are. Landing system is on.
$2,500.
Here we are. We can arm the localizer. And the localizer is captured. Approach mode will kick in any minute now, right there. No, I haven't been to Canada in real life. I've been to most places, but I didn't do Canada yet. There is a wedding happening in July, so I might go to that. That's in Toronto. And approach mode is going to kick in. Here we go. Approach mode is done. Let's go manage speed. Here we are, and we can go flaps one. There we go, and we can go flaps two as well. Let's put on the APU. And tell the cabin.
Flight attendants, please prepare for landing.
Flaps two. And let's get ready with approach mode. And is that the runway in sight? There's the runway. Come on, that glide slope thing isn't really catching fast, is it? Let's slow down. Flaps three and drop the gear. Okay. Come on. Is captured. Here we go. Full flaps. And there's Toronto. There's the runway in sight. Bit overcast. Terminal is there on the right. The ice. There we go. Let's leave here. Whoops. Kidding me, I forgot to ooh, a bit drunk there. Okay, here we go. Welcome to Toronto. Let's park up at the main terminal. Park up at Terminal 3. Actually, no, we'll park up at Terminal 1, I think. Get out of the way. They just stop there and wait for you to move, and then they carry on with their journey. Let's see, where can I park? There we go, 139. Right here. 143, sorry, or what is it? 139, yep. There we are. We are parked. Park and brake on. Oh, Algiers. You do like the French territories, don't you? There we go. APU on. And let's switch off the engines. There we are, engines are off, fuel pumps. Off, ideas off, here we go. Let's call the jetway. There's the jetway. Power, catering and baggage. There we are. Everything is off and seat belts can come off. There we are. We've got external power. APU can come off. And there we are. Emergency exits can go off. And there we go. All good. Welcome to Toronto. There we are. Bit of icing on the tail there, but okay. All right, that's it for today. I'm planning to do something in the evening as well. MSAP, if you're around, yeah, pop in. I might be doing a group flight in Cessnas with Solo. So you're always welcome to join in the Sobo Cessna. But in the meantime, I'll see you on the next one. Thank you for popping in, everyone. And yeah, no worries. You take care, my friend. All right, have a good evening. Bye-bye.